We're at the bins for another fun-filled day of digging. It's very rainy and blustery. And it looks like it's a very busy. It might be because the kids are out of school, so it's a family affair of bins digging. So we'll go in, see if we can find a cart. I saw one hanging out on the side of the building, so we'll see if maybe I can grab that one, but let's go in, see what we can find. My goal is 25 pounds, so let's see if we can get that much. All right, let's go. Here it is, I found it. First stop, shoes. Those are. They look kind of like Doc Martens, actually.
So
thank you.
think this is real fur.
Thank you.
this up and come back if I have to. It's really tangled. My lookup pile. Thank you. person alive.
Thank you.
Alright, here is our cart. She overflowing and packed. So why don't we get started and go through what I got? Surprisingly, a lot of stuff. I don't know why I'm surprised every time, but I am. I think I'm gonna start up here and then I'm gonna pile stuff on. This is a leather belt made in USA. The brand is right there, but I can't super make it out right now, but nice belt buckle on it. A planter, I would assume, hand painted, but it's also a music box and it does work. But maybe it's not a planter. I don't know why you would want a planter music box, but it is vintage. The paint job is a little meh, but for 69 cents a pound, I'll give the shot. You might have seen these. I think there was like 9, but I decided to just get 4. They are Pier 1 hand-painted terracotta. Just because I just didn't want to get more than that, to be honest. So I got 4. They should sell pretty well. Next is a hand-painted, either made in China or made in Japan, cup and saucer. Really pretty. No chips or cracks. Next are, I think these are vintage. I've sold the like bowl before. Oh my gosh, look at this. I feel like Marv from Home Alone. And so I think these are vintage little ice cream bowls, but I've never seen the spoons before. So I got that. Next, a new in-box set, 5-piece, little cup plates, silverware, moon and stars. A Badgley Mishka pink kind of quilted bag, pink. Inside is in good condition. Little wear on the hardware, but overall not bad. Some light color transfer. Next, these are new with tags. Pink Victoria's Secret leggings. They are specific to the Oregon Ducks. So it does close a lot of the people that would be interested, but they are new with tags, so I decided to get those. If anything, I can put them on Facebook Market. Next, a vintage pair of evergreen coverall overalls for kids. The size is cut out, but we'll just measure it when we put it up. Very cute. A hand-painted tray, no brand, has that weathered look, but I might keep it because I like it. Next, Stranger Things, size small shirt. Looks like these go for about 15 to 20. Next, Izzato Anthropology, size large. Like a neon dotted polka dotted top with a zip back. Next, a woven, colorful shoulder bag with like tassel. No brand on it though. Next is a vintage scarf, hand rolled, 100% silk, Japan Sally Gi or G. Really pretty scarf. Got a bunch of jeans, silver, size 34. Oh, these might be vintage. They're made in Hong Kong. I don't usually find the larger sizes. But yeah, these look to be in decent condition. Always check the crotch. Got those. Next, another pair, I think from the same person, because I believe it's also a 34. It is a 34, also made in Hong Kong. Garfield vintage tie, pause addiction, polyester, that are really cute. This is a lucky, if I can find the right side up, lucky size large, like an open vest. I don't think it like clasps or anything, it's just like a flowy open vest. Good condition. Next is a vintage Ropa de Playa y Mas, Combo San Lucas t-shirt, like a fish design and some glitter, and it is single stitch, so I got that. Next is a vintage Tess Paris Milano size 10 top. I don't know if this is, no, it's polyester. Goodwill wanted $7.99. Button down front. Market and Spruce size 12. I believe this is a Stitch Fix brand. Usually sells relatively well. I might look it up before I go though, because I haven't sold something in a little while. But they're in good shape. Goodwill wanted $7.99, and they're a good size. So next, a vintage bodysuit. It's good condition, underwire. Again, vintage lingerie sells really well. Adana 40D made in USA. Maurice's extra large. Long sleeve. Crocs, these look really unused. Size 10. Goodwill wanted $9.99. This I haven't sold before, Live and Let Live. They wanted $12.99. It is new with tags, $45. So we'll give it a go. It has like a tie by the like waist hip area. It's a cute shirt. It has like a metallic thread through it. Next is a Banana Republic size medium. Like a satin tank top. Really lightweight, so it offsets some of the cost of some of the heavier items. This I just need to look up. Maggie Barnes. I don't know if I've sold that before, so I need to look her up. This will shut. There we go. Good condition though. Thibault, size 40, leather, velcro, little block heel, sandal, Goodwill wanted, $20. Next is bullhide, one size, made in Mexico, Team Dream. Cowboy hat. Probably post about 35. Next is a cabby size small sheer floral tank. Really lightweight. So again, offset some of the costs and I can post it for a little cheaper. This I got for someone. I'm not sure if I'm going to get it or not, but it's just a turtle print. I don't know what the brand is or anything. Like long sleeve. It looks new. Top. So possibly a gift for that one. This is a potential Longchamp. I'm not super familiar with authenticating Longchamp. I have found a fake one at the business before. And I thought it was real, but I posted it and someone said that's fake. And so I researched a lot more and really compared the design, especially on this leather. And I could see that it was. So that's kind of why I was looking at this. They have like this universal, like, print on the leather, but I'll get it, research it, and see. It does have some corner wear, but we'll see. Here's the zipper. Okay. This I just have, and it's like my favorite, so I just got this for me, a pink large. I have it in like red, white, and gray, something like that, I don't know, but I just have it myself. Next, a pair of Steve Madden tassel heels, leather, size 8.5, Goodwill wanted $9.99. Good condition. We have a Cossique. Cossique is a brand of Lane Bryant, I believe. 42D, the lingerie brand. Or the lingerie side. Good condition. This is a vintage, like, roller bag, but it's easily compact with all the Hawaiian islands on it. It should sell relatively well. So I got that. Next, I looked this up, I wasn't sure about it, Voyager, and I found out it's a vintage brand that was made for bikers, like cyclists, which makes sense because it has that on the side. And they actually sell for a decent amount. I couldn't find this one exactly, but the bike seat bags, like a seat you can attach to your bike seat, those were up for like 50. So, and this has like a solid back, which must be beneficial cycling, or maybe you attach it somewhere, but that was a decent find. There was another thing I said I would go back for, but I lost it, so we're just gonna get this one. Next, no brand, but a really cute embroidered floral pom-pom accent handbag. Just needs a lint rolling. Next, a vintage. Not sure if it's leather. I'm not sure. Goodwill wanted $4.99. Just a shoulder bag, black shoulder bag. Next, needs a cleaning. Viavi. I've never heard of the brand, but it looks a lot like vintage Dunienburg. So I'll look at that. This is a vintage Disney size large Disney store. Pooh Bear, Eeyore, long sleeve print with hearts. That's cute. Next, orange and black vintage backpack Campways. I could not also find this one listed, but I could find other Campway items, vintage items, and they were also selling for around 50. So we will post this one. It's in pretty good shape, has a little staining there, but overall not bad. Next, pair of Fry sandals. Needs to be conditioned a little bit. It looks like it's missing a stud, but not bad. Next, a pair of moccasins, vintage moccasins, hand beaded. This feels like rabbit fur, and it might be leather and just really worn. It probably is. Oh, it looks like it has a hole. But I am still gonna get them. Someone can patch it if they want. This is a belt. Very interesting design. I'll research it a little more. Maybe it's missing a piece. I think so. The little clasp piece that puts it together. So, I'm not gonna get that. Next, a size 4X Lawrence Kazar. I have sold this brand before. I've never found it in this size. And I love the print. Really cool. Sequined. Got that. Let me take this out. Next, a pair of Cole Haan. Like, small wedge. It's like there's some scuffing, but we'll work on that. Silver. Next, a Relic by Fossil. Bamboo handle, I think faux. And faux leather. Bag, but good condition. Okay. Next, a vintage top clasp handbag. It looks a lot like a bag I sold before. I think the brand was Bags by Dorian, but I'll look it up. It's really good quality. Really nice bag. Okay, let's move some stuff around. Next, Bueno. Not a high seller, or not a high dollar seller, but it's a really cute design in relatively good condition. So I got that one. Next, I really like this one. Vintage shoulder bag, leather interior. A pair of Ralph Lauren wedges. They look like a smaller size, maybe like a 6. I already showed that. Next, a Travelon. It needs a cleaning on the front. Oh my. But the inside is in good condition. And it's a bright pink color. And last, I got this blanket. That's the only issue I found, but it is made in Austria. It's a linen cotton blend. I did sell something with this type of pattern on it, but it was only like placemats for your table, and it sold really well, and it looks like the same type of label. So I decided to get this. Sometimes if you ask, they'll give you a set price on the blanket, which is usually $5, but it might be better just to weigh it separately at the $1.29 a pound, because you'll probably get it cheaper, obviously depending on the weight, but this one is probably 3 pounds, maybe, so a little cheaper getting it by the pound instead of a flat price, but yes, look at all that we did. It was really crazy in here, but still found a ton of stuff. So, I will be posting it all eventually on eBay, Poshmark, and Mercari after I do the cleanings and yada yada to get them ready to go. I also work full time. This is just something I do for fun. I think some people consider what my idea of fun is, but I think it's fun. So, yes. All this shall be posted soon. Another fun time where we found a lot of good stuff, so pretty happy. So yes, hope you guys had a good time. And until next time, see you later.